Well, YouTube now a $15 billion business for Google, and lots of people want a piece of that, including lots of kids around town. Well, recently we went to an event called Vlog University. This is a weekend conference that was teaching YouTube hopefuls how to turn their dreams into reality.
10 million hot dogs.
People watch billions of YouTube videos every day, and someone has to make them.
They think, like, it's this crazy glamorous lifestyle. It can be, but there's also so much hard work that goes into it.
Justine started making videos over a decade ago. She now has over 6 million followers and makes a living creating videos inspired by technology.
So these are the main phones that we're going to be checking out today.
We caught up with her at an event she headlined called Vlog University. The two-day conference aims to teach attendees everything they need to know about getting a YouTube channel off the ground, from cameras and lighting to editing, and of course, making money.
The challenge of the younger people is to get the parents to understand that, hey, support me, I'll make more money than you do.
I don't think it's too late to start a YouTube. I think everyone has something of value to add to the internet.
Jessica Schrody runs a channel called She Really Had a Baby. She likes the flexible lifestyle of entrepreneurship, but knows it's not easy.
It's a lot of work, yes, especially when you're not super big and you don't have the budget.
Joey Hall hopes to turn his personal vlogs into something more serious.
I really want to reach out and meet other YouTubers and collaborate and just really understand how they produce their content, really, and maybe get some tips and some ideas about how I can approach it.
In the YouTube world, just because you make it doesn't mean people will flock to watch. For every video with a million views, many others garner just a few hundred, which brings us back to Justine.
I think my biggest advice is just start and make mistakes. It's okay. It's great to see where you started, and it's even more rewarding to see where you can go.
Vlog University tells me they're going to hold these conferences in various cities throughout the U.S. in 2020. They're also selling a streaming package on their website. You can learn more about that on mine. Just go to richontech.tv. But Raul and Shali,
wow,
pretty simple advice from Justine. You got to just start.
Yep.
But that's the tough part because you got to get the equipment. I guess you could use your phone, but you just got to do it.
I tried to do it for my daughter, and then I messed up my own email account. I didn't know how to do that. And then it went into the Google and went into all these different things. And I was like, I don't know how to do any of this.
I tried to set up a YouTube account for my kids because they watched through mine, and I got all the Minecraft videos of mine. And YouTube is like, rule number one, no one under 13 could be on YouTube. I'm like, wait, what?
What?
So how do these kids can't even, it's illegal for them to watch YouTube. Okay.
Yeah,
that's my excuse for them.
Yeah, I don't get it. But hey, we've had a bunch of people here who have YouTube channels, and they're rolling up in the Ferraris and stuff, so something's working for them. Rich DeMuro.
Okay.
Yeah, oh, you know, YouTube
Do a story
stars.
With them.
Yeah, YouTube stars.
My little, I posted, what was the gentleman's name? Was it FaZe? Do you remember FaZe? He was on our show last week. He's 23 years old, and he built like a whole empire on this YouTube.
Yeah.
So he went and posted, by the way, he was on the Fox 5 Morning News. A mom, who's a friend of mine, messaged me and said, my son is freaking out right now because you interviewed, FaZe.
It is unrecognizable. Like when we were their age, there were three, maybe four networks, right? And we had TVs that you had to watch, and maybe you had a VCR or something like that. Now, you know, the celebrities were the people in Hollywood, and Hollywood was this glam and this whole thing. Now it's,
YouTube.
People who are working, and it's hard work. It's not like
it's a lot of work.
I have some sayings. One of them is TV. It takes longer than you think. And so they're producing some really good content. Mm-hmm. It's just...
It takes work.
It's a full-time
That's
job
true.
Plus. All right, switching gears. You want to see some snow? Let's do it. Let's
Please.
Go.